Good morning, beloved. Happy Sunday to you all. It's another privilege that the Lord has given unto us that we can be here together this morning. We are here to God alone be all the glory this morning. For life He has given unto every one of us in abundance. It's a great privilege that none of us can be able to pay for it. And the only thing we can be able to say to God is to say thank you. The only thing we can give to God is to appreciate Him for how far He has kept every one of us. This Sunday is the last Sunday in the month of June. We are not hearing bad news from anywhere. We are not running etasketa over our neighbors, over our friends, over our loved ones. This is the grace of God that has been speaking on our behalf. I pray the Lord will continue to rescue us all in the name of Jesus. Good morning once again. God bless. This morning I'll be reading quickly from the book of Psalm, chapter 139, from verse 23 to 24. Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way of everlasting. Praise the Lord. The psalmist is asking, it was David here that is asking the Lord, that search me if there's anything in me that is not being placed unto you. Test me, go through my heart, if whatever I have done is contrary to your will. How many of us that can be able to say such, even to our neighbors, not to talk of God that can see all? How many of us that can be able to tell God that God search me if there's any iniquities in me? If there's anything that I'm doing that is not aligned to your will for my life? How many of us that can be able to say that? This is a question that many of us have to ask ourselves. If you want to know your identity in Christ, this is the time you have to ask God and say, search me. If you know who truly you will call yourself a disciple of God, if truly you say you are a Christian, you have to ask God this question constantly. And say, God, search me if there is anything in me that is not pleasing you. Search me. If I'm doing it right, search me. If my thought is your thought, search me. If there is no sin in me, we have to ask God. Because the more you ask God, you can be able to do things that will be bringing honor to the Lord. When you are asking God, then you can be able to wash your way. You can be able to tame your tongue, that you don't speak evil of others. You can be able to do things that will bring honor to the name of the Lord. I pray the Lord Himself will help us to continue in the name of Jesus. This is the time we have to ask the Lord to reveal ourselves to ourselves. Because many of us, we don't know ourselves. So when you ask God this question continuously, then you tell God, search me. That God search me, reveal myself to myself, but to know where I have missed it. To know if all I'm doing is being pleasing unto you. We have to ask God for this question. We have to ask God. We have to get our mind right. We have to get our mind into the things of God. We have to get our mind to align with the word of God. It is the amount of the word of God that you have in you that can be able to help you. When there is no word of God in you, you are empty. You are just kind of an empty barrel that makes sound. You are empty because it's the word of God that you have in you that can be able to correct you, that can be able to reprove you when you are making mistakes, that can be able to tell you whatever you are doing is not right. It is the amount of the word that you have imparted in you, that you have in you, that you can be able to use. You can be able to make it right. Many of us, we wanted to please God, but the flesh in us is not allow us. So it is the word of God. Constantly when you are reading the word of God, when you listen to messages, this is the word that will improve you, that will correct you, that will improve you, that will make you to be pleasing unto the Lord. I pray the Lord will open our mind this morning in the name of Jesus. The Lord will teach us how to go with it, that we will not do things of the world. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says it is the amount of the word of God that you have acquired in your heart that you can be able to use when things are not working well. It is the word you have in your mouth. The Bible says the word of God is yea and amen. It is that word that you have that can be able to help you when you are facing challenges in life, when torment is around you, when you are facing difficulties. It is that word that can be able to correct you. It is the word of God that you have that can be be able to help you. I pray the Lord will continually to help us in the name of Jesus. The Lord will teach us how to go with Him. He will direct our path and begin to speak with us continuously in the name of Jesus. That we will not miss it in the things of God. In the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord, somebody. The scripture says in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16, it says, all scripture is given by correction. It's the inspiration of God. It's for profit. It's for profitable for the doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. It is not, you know, some people when they hear messages, they get offended in it. It is not to get you angry. The word of God is not to make you angry. It's to make you to look at yourself. That what is it that I'm doing that is not aligned with the things of God? When you are angry, that means you know the word is really speaking to you. Then you check yourself. Correct yourself. If you are doing it before, that is not right. Tell God, please, just reveal myself to myself. I want to know who I am in you. I want to know my identity in you. I just pray this morning that this gathering will not be in vain today in the name of Jesus. That the Lord will open ourselves to ourselves, that we can be able to understand Him better. It is the word of God that can change us. It is the one that can correct us. It is that only word that can reprove us from every of our wrongdoing. Your friends may not be able to tell you because they don't want you to feel offended. They don't want you to get angry. No, it is the true one of God that can be able to speak to you. Either you like it or you don't like it, you just have to yield with the Lord. And I pray that Lord will continuously to correct us in the name of Jesus. The word of God is the one that can help us. There's nobody that can correct you. The things of God, you see the way the world is going? There's nothing good in this world, nothing. They just want to frustrate people to shift your focus from God. But the word of God you acquire, the things of God, the word of God that you acquire that can be able to tell you all is well. Calm down, just relax, wait patiently unto the Lord, and God will help us in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord, somebody. Creating me anew. Oh,
Forgiven every unrighteousness, oh Lord, Father, we ask you to cleanse us, oh Lord, and make us
holding on to yourself. In the name of Jesus, that whatever that pushes us against you, Father, we ask you to have mercy unto us. In the name of Jesus Christ, every sin, Father, we ask you to forgive us, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Father, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy. In the book of Proverbs chapter 28, verse 13 says, he said, those who confess the sin, he said, God will have mercy unto them. But for, he said, for those who confess them and turn away from it, he said, God will show them mercy. God will show them mercy. He will be merciful unto them. He said, but for those that they did not even care about it, he said, they will be condemned. May we never be condemned. Begin to confess unto him. Don't say you are holy, you are perfect. It is only God that is holy. Begin to confess unto the Lord this morning. Say, God, I need nothing this morning but your mercy. I need mercy. Mercy is all I need this morning. I'm not here to ask him for justice. All I need is your mercy. Make us to be perfect in the name of Jesus. Every sin in us, let it be forgiven. Every iniquity, oh Lord, we ask you to forgive us. In the name of Jesus, as a church, oh Lord, we have sinned. We have sinned, oh Lord, and come short of your glory. Let your mercy begin to speak on our behalf this morning. Let us begin to encounter you, brethren, as we are gathered this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we pray for your mercy. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father, because you have cleansed us. Thank you for a new mind. Thank you for a new spirit that you have restored unto us. May your name alone be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, we have confessed. Let us begin to give thanks to the Lord this morning. It is only the people that know how to think that can be able to appreciate God. Many of us are not happy because of what we are expecting the Lord to do for us. But being alive this morning is a great gift. It's a great gift that is even beyond what you are expecting, because when there is no life, whatever you have is useless. So it is the life that you have in you this morning that you are going to use to praise God. Say, God, I'm grateful this morning. For making me to be able to see the last Sunday of the month of June, Father, I'm grateful. Father, I've come to say thank you to you this morning in the name of Jesus. It is only those who are alive that can praise the Lord. Begin to appreciate the Lord this morning. With all your heart, be thankful unto the Lord for how far the Lord has kept you, kept your family, kept all your loved ones, kept the church of God. Be thankful unto the Lord. Begin to say, God, I've come to say thank you for everything. Daddy, I've come to appreciate your wonders in this family. Daddy, we have come to say thank you for uniting us like never before. We have come to say thank you for your grace that is speaking forth like never before. Jehovah will thank you, oh Lord, for grace, oh Lord, that you have shown unto us. Thank you for this month, oh Lord. Thank you for how far you have kept us. Thank you for the testimony that is flowing like a river in us. Thank you, Father, for everything. We cannot thank you enough. Thank you, Father, for sustaining us. Thank you, Father, for keeping us together. Thank you for loving us. Thank you, Father, because you are everything to us. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let us begin to commit today's service into the hands of the Lord. Begin to tell the Lord, Father, I'm in your presence this morning. Father, your blessing, let it be released unto me. Your blessing, let it be given unto us. In the name of Jesus, begin to tell the Lord whatever you want the Lord to do for you. Begin to confess unto him. Begin to tell the Lord your desires this morning. Say, God bless you. In the name of Jesus, Father, draw me more closer to you, O Lord, that I can be able to be useful in your kingdom. In the name of Jesus, begin to tell the Lord this morning, Father, I've come to your presence this morning, change my life, turn my life around in the name of Jesus. Father, I want you, O Lord, to encounter my life today. In the name of Jesus, I don't want to be the same, O Lord. I want you to come and renew my mind. I want you to come and help me, O Lord. Help me to be useful. Help me to be useful. In the name of Jesus, draw me nearer, O Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we have come to give thanks to you. Even the service is in your hands, O Lord, Father, King of glory, as many that are here this morning, we pray that you should touch every life in the name of Jesus. As your soul will be speaking, you are God of your word. Father, let your word, King of glory, let it be clearer to us. In the name of Jesus, we pray, O Lord, that every mind that are here this morning, let them begin to perceive your word in the name of Jesus. Let them understand the word that will be coming forth. In the name of Jesus, every offensive spirit, let it be calm. In the name of Jesus, we pray, O Lord, King of glory, that your word that will be speaking today will bring healing unto those who are sick among us. In the name of Jesus, it will bring deliverance to those who are oppressed among us. In the name of Jesus, and at the end, your name will be exalted. Father, we have come to give thanks to you. We appreciate you for everything you are going to do with us today. Blessed be your holy name. In the name of Jesus, Father, we saw today's service to the word of Jesus. Father, the blood of Jesus, we say, we put through the blood of Jesus on our doorpost that when sickness comes, they will pass over it. Father, this morning we begin to pray the blood of Jesus upon each every one of us this morning, the blood of Jesus upon our children, the blood of Jesus upon everything that we lay our hands upon in this week. In the name of Jesus, let the blood of Jesus begin to speak on our behalf. In the name of Jesus, Father, we pray that the blood of Jesus, O Lord, will be sufficient for every one of us. Thank you for the blood. We appreciate it. We give glory to you because you are here with us. We pray, O Lord, that today's service, O Lord, will be blessed, O Lord. In the name of Jesus, that the gathering of the righteous will be acceptable unto you. In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, we say thank you. Thank you, Father, because you are here with us. We give glory to you because you are faithful forever. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed with thanksgiving. Amen. It is time to praise the King of Kings. It is time to praise him. He is our heritage. It is time to praise him. It is time to worship him. Our salvation, the one that can do wonders. It is time to honor him. The one that can do what nobody else can do. The only thing you can give to God is to give him praises. That is the only productive things that you can give to the Lord. And when you praise him, the Bible says when you praise God, his blessing will come down. May we receive God's blessing in the name of Jesus. It's time to praise him. Praise the Lord, somebody. Come, let's praise the Lord. Oh, come, let's praise the Lord. Thank you.
Yeah.
appreciate you this morning.
Thank you, Lord, because you are forever alive.
Thank you, Lord.
And when you are forever alive, you are completely a winner.
Yes,
so now we give you all the praise.
Hallelujah.
We will return all the glory unto you.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name of God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
as we continue, Father, we will continue with us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we have
Amen.
I want to welcome you all to the Power of Exaltation Church of Christ. It is not because you are clever that you are here. It is because He decided you should be here this morning. We are always in this place this morning, every Sunday, in this place. We meet at 11:30. We start our service at 11:30. We start our service with a prayer from 11:30 to 11:35. Then we have praises and worship, what we just said just now. I'm sure everybody is blessed. After that, we have time for testimonies and time for children's songs. And then from 12 o'clock and until 1 o'clock is time we have reserved for the main sermon. So at this moment, I want to invite testimonies. Sister Elizabeth, please come and share your testimony. Because of time, please just try, remember to keep your testimony short and just a summary. Praise the Lord.
Glory be unto your holy name. Hallelujah be unto your holy name. I just thank never desist from praising your name. Our voice will exalt you. Because you know you are stronger than them. Because we should not be afraid of them. Because you are going to put your word in our mouth so that we can be able to tell them who is on the driver's seat. You are our Father, and for you to be there for us. Father God, I just want to say thank you. I just want to say thank you, Lord, for everything. Amen. Father God, I accept my praise and my thanks in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Everything is double. It's like I'm not happy, everything is double. Praise the Lord. Next on testimonies is Pastor Mercy. While she gives a testimony, can you, Mr. Lawrence, can you please get the children ready? Thank you.
Praise the Lord. The Bible says, there's no other name given to mankind in which we can be saved, except the name of Jesus Christ. Indeed, the name of Jesus saved for those that believe in that name. I want to bless the Lord. I want to appreciate God for everything. There's one group I created, like a kind of our whole school students, so we are many in that group. So there's one day I was at work, the Spirit of God laid it in the man to just create an a group, like kind of to pray together. So when I send it to the platform, a lot of people embrace it anyway. So we have been doing this this prayer every last Saturday of the month. So we always connect on Zoom. So those people that are connected, yeah, it's always good. But this last month when we are doing the one we were supposed to do. So there's this one of my dear friend. I just said to her personally, like, are you not connecting with us? Normally she told me she couldn't be able to download the Zoom, but I just said to her, I don't know anyhow, just connect with us. Not knowing she was traveling to Jos. So when I sent to her, she wasn't respond. So we continued, we finished our prayer. Almost to finish, like a prayer point arrived that we just have to pray for everybody in the group. So the second day on Sunday, because that time we were still doing a service at home. So immediately we finished service at home, she sent to me like, this is what happened, and yesterday when I sent to her, she was trying to respond, reply my message. This was that happened, that these kidnappers came along there to them. Came to them, so they were shooting. So their car started some assaulting because they didn't know where they are going. It was started some assaulting that two of the people came out from the car because they were scared of maybe something will happen at the end of when the car stopped. So later they got to know that when they came, the kidnappers came to the car to knock if they are still alive. So when they noted that no response, they just left them, they ran away. So a soldier came to rescue them. And after the same morning, they got to know that two of the people in the car, they kidnapped those two people. And nothing happened to them. Nothing. That's why that the car was so assaulting like that. Nothing. No touch. Nothing. I just want to bless the name of God this morning. Because there were two that is part of the group. That nothing. That we are not being kind of more or a mini silence for those people. I want to bless God. She told me this morning that she's giving thanksgiving in the church today. That is the reason I'm doing it for her. I want to bless the Lord. That may the name of the Lord forever be praised. People that don't know the power of prayer. Sincerely, the power of prayer is really good. So learn how to build yourself, no matter what. Raise a prayer of altar for yourself. I pray the Lord will be hearing unto everyone of us in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Always thank God for all of life, for protection. Hallelujah. Moving on, it's time for the children. We'll put our hands together, please, as the children come to praise over yourself.
You. You are welcoming the name of the Lord. You are welcoming the
Praise God, somebody. Now the bigger hallelujah. Let the living soul shout a bigger hallelujah. Let all of your life stand up and shout a bigger hallelujah. Somebody says something, say if you put 1,000 alarm at the mortuary, the dead cannot worship God. The dead cannot listen to the alarm. The dead cannot make up. But here we are healthy and bouncing. Shout a bigger hallelujah! The devil who has loved the battle. Many people know that devil has loved the battle. The devil you have loved the battle. Over my life you have loved the battle. Over my plan you have loved your battle. Over my children you have loved the battle. Over my status you have loved the battle. Because God is going to turn things around in my favor. I said God will turn it around in your favor. God will turn it around in your situation. In the name of Jesus Christ. Just lift up your hand to heaven and begin to worship. Say, Lord, I have come to do something alone, but to worship you this morning. I am here to worship you. Lord, receive all my praise. Receive all my worship. Receive my praise, O Lord. Receive my worship. I have come to worship you. Let only your name be exalted. Let your name alone be lifted high. Let all glory be given to you. Let all honor be given to you. Lord, do what you are able to do in this atmosphere. Lord, do what you are able to do. Perform your wonders, perform your miracle, touch our life, transform our destiny, change our story, live with the testimony. Visit us this month like never before. Visit our situation like never before. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. We're going to pray a prayer that God, every sin that might be in me, have mercy. Let the blood of your son be enough. Purge me of my sin. Purge me of my sin. Purge me of my sin. Our prayer will be useless if we are still living the old way. If we not find a reason to say, Lord, I am sorry, I am going to live another way, another life in your favor. I am changing completely to walk in your direction. Thank you, Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. I know my God will turn it around. I have seen my God turn it around. There are so many, many, many troubles in my life. I know God has turned it around. I know. Yeah.
told it before. I am here where you have told it before. There are many situations in my life that you are taking me over before. You are taking me out of this situation. Whether this one is not a setup. Father, take me out of this present situation. Take me out of this situation. Change my story. Change my status. There are many places I've been told that I see it is not possible. But with God, I've seen you coming to answer me. I have seen you have gone into my life before. I know you have the capability, you have the ability, you have the will to do it. Father, turn this one again. Turn this situation again. Turn these challenges again. Let that be changed. Let that be changed. Change in my favor. Change for my glory. Change for my healing. Change in my love. Lack of you for here. Let turn it on. Let it turn it on. Thank you. For in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In the book of Ezekiel, chapter 21, 27, the Bible mentions something three times. It says overthrow, overthrow, overthrow. It says I will continue to overthrow until you get to the right person that holds it. You go to pray the prayer. Lord, whenever my blessing is, I need an overthrow. Whatever power sitting upon my glory, let that be overthrown. Whatever power sitting on my health, let that overthrow them. Say, Lord, overthrow it as it comes to me. Because it belongs to me, my health belongs to me, my status belongs to me, my marriage belongs to me, my children is mine. Let it overthrow. Every power that is sitting upon my glory, every power sitting upon my glory, upon my destiny.
To my children, we say back to the sender. We say back
to the sender. We say back to the sender. We say back to the sender. We say back to the sender. Back to the sender. Fears of man. The heart of man, who can see except you? That's what we have come to today. I will say, Lord, every of our misfortune, every of thing we have done, in contrary to your will, Father, have mercy. We have prayed for your forgiveness of our sin, Father, have mercy. Let the blood of your Son be enough for everybody this morning, and let us be purged of our sin in the name of Jesus. Lord, as I go to your word, speak through me, touch my tongue. Let me speak your word with accuracy. Through your weight in this house, let the devil know that you are the boss. Through everything that is contrary to the will of God out of this building, let the will of the devil be shattered in the name of Jesus. Father, let your word be established in our life. Father, I hide behind the cross. Let your Son alone be seen and not me. I decrease while you increase. Let your word go out with power. Let it go out with deliverance. Let it set your children loose in the name of Jesus. As men that come here today, battling in their hearts, worried for what is going to happen to them, thinking about their next step of life. Father, let your word be established in their life, and let the testimony be visit them now, in the name of Jesus. Let that be a breakthrough in their situation. Let that be a testimony about their situation, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the devil know they have come to encounter you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And they will be living here today, don't let them be the same way they came. Let them go with their miracle, let them go with their blessing. Let your mercy follow them. Let your power go with them. Everywhere that the devil has molested them in the past, if the devil tries after this service, Father, let the devil be corrected with debts. In the name of Jesus Christ, every power that awaits them in their home or awaits them at the door, that says when they leave this building, they're going to take them to fear out of their life. Father, let your power go ahead of them. Father, Lord, God, let your word manifest our destiny. I promise you, when the trumpets sound, Lord, we want to be a candle of heaven. We want to reign with you. It will be a waste of time for us to get miracle in heads and we lose our soul. Father, grant us eternity. For in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Praise the Lord, somebody. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Shout if you can, hallelujah. In the sister is praying, the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Today, I'm going to speak shortly on what I've captioned. Just do it. Tell people, just do it. Just do it. And I pray that Lord will speak to you in the name of Jesus Christ. I'll be using the book of John chapter 2, verse 1 to 10. John chapter 2, verse 1 to 10. It's a very familiar story that every one of us might have heard about it or know about it. It's the first miracle that Jesus did at Cana. Look at what happened. The Bible says, the book of John chapter 2, verse 1, and I read. And the third day, there was a marriage in Cana of Galilee. And the mother of Jesus was there. And both Jesus was called and his disciples to the marriage. Verse 3. And when they were, and when they waited, wanted wine, the mother of Jesus said unto him, they have no wine. Verse 4. Jesus said unto her, woman, what have I to do with thee? My hour is not yet come. Verse 5. His mother said unto the servant, whatsoever is said unto you, do it. Verse 6. And there were sent there six water pots to a full, after the manner of the purifying of Jews, containing two or three fecals apiece. Verse 7. Jesus said unto them, fill the water pots with water, and fill them up to the brim. And he said unto them, draw out now, and bear unto the governor of the feast, and they bear it. Verse 9. When the ruler of the feast has tasted the wine with the water that was made wine, and knew not whence it was, the servants withdrew the water near. The governor of the feast called the bridegroom, verse 10, and said unto him, every man at the beginning doeth set forth good wine. And when men have well drunk, then that which is worse, but thou hast kept the good wine until now. May the Lord bless the raising of this word in the name of Jesus Christ. How many people know this story? I think even the children, most of them will know this story. I pray that heaven will speak to you through this word in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord was speaking about the invitation they offered Jesus and the mother. And what at the garden of the marriage ceremony. And the wine was finished. And they needed a support. They need something to make sure that the feast keep going. And the mother went to Jesus and said, son, something is happening and we need you. We need your assistance here. And Jesus turned and said, no, God, this is not my time. It is not yet time to do anything. I'm not ready for this. But because his mother knows the son that she has, and she knows the authority that Jesus carried, she just said, it is not even wait for what Jesus will say. He just tell them whatever he said, whatever he told you to do, do what? And that's where I'm going to draw my message today. What has Jesus been telling you of late? And what do you know about Jesus that you haven't done? Tell me, but your miracle is lying behind your obedience. Sometimes most of us, what we do mostly is we wait for miracle without wanting to do anything. The Bible passage speaks about what Jesus, even when Jesus was ready to do something, Jesus asked them to take step. He said, fill the pots with water. And that is where we as Christians mix it. We don't want to fill the pots with water. We need a change, but we don't want to take a step. We don't want to do anything. We want Jesus to do everything for us. I always say, is a responsible Christian that doesn't want to do anything, I expect God to do everything for them. There's always a part for us to play. There's a part for me to play for my miracle to happen. For something to happen, we need to be able to play our part. We need to be able to do what is told us to do. But sadly enough, that most of us, we do not want to do what it told us to do. And this situation here is a situation between an embarrassment. The family that's having that marriage is about to run to an embarrassment. Because something they needed to feed their visitor has, it's no more there. It's finished. The shame is running up there. I see heaven wiping away your shame in the name of Jesus. I don't know who's waiting for your shame, but I feel so strongly today that the Lord is putting away your shame in the name of Jesus. There are people that think you had before, now you don't have that, they are laughing at you. All the thoughts you've left and you are suffering, they are laughing at you. But Jesus' intervention is to be had today. I say your shame is over in the name of Jesus Christ. The mother called to Jesus. He said, something is not right here. We need you. And then most of us meet Jesus at any point in our life, especially me. I don't know about you. There are situations in our life that Jesus alone can solve. There are situations in our life that takes him a little to take us out of the situation. And he wants to do it. That is the most amazing part of Jesus. Jesus is always ready for us. He's always ready for you to transform your destiny. He's always ready to put away your shame. He's always ready to heal you of your sickness. But there's a part for you and myself to play. And that part is where we always miss it as Christians. Some of us, we have substituted our path with prayer. Prayer is good. Don't misquote me. But there are things we need to do physically, action. But most of it, we translated it to prayer. We thought it's only prayer, prayer, everything. Prayer is very good. But after prayer, have you obeyed what he told you to do? Have you took action on what I told you to do? You can imagine people in that marriage, if they started praying, Father, we need more wine. We need the transformation here. It may not happen. Jesus gave them an instruction how to get to their destiny. There's always an instruction from Christ how for you and myself to go to our next level. There's always a laid down rules for you on what to do and what not to do. And God is saying here that if you can obey my son and listen to him, you have a direct access to me. All I promise you, I can do it. All what I wrote down, in my word, it is my word and it's my integrity. And there is a part for you and myself to play. They run to Jesus because there is a need. Everybody will come to a point in their life that they will have a need. If you don't have a need now, keep growing. A man will give you a testimony. He runs his life as if nobody lives, nobody controls it. He says, my life belongs to me. But at the point in his life, he got everything, he was okay, and something, just little things come up, and everything lost. One time, just everything just wiped off. Until he went back to God. And started praying. Come back to God, started obeying him, following the instruction, living his life for Christ. And today, he's even back up from where he was before. There's a need for you and myself to understand that there's a shine to our blessing. There's a shine to our breakthrough. And that shine alone can only be gotten by Christ. People will say, but people that are not Christian, they are rich. Of course, yes. If I say blessing, I'm not talking about richness. Blessing gives you riches. Blessing is a big word. Some of people that are rich, go and ask them, most of them, they don't have peace. Some of them cannot even sleep in the night. There's a person of Jesus, and there's a principle of Jesus. And as Christian, I always encourage people to embrace both. The principle of Jesus, and also the person of Jesus. The person of Jesus is the one that tells you about righteousness, holiness, how to walk right, how to do right, how to do everything right. He talks about heaven. He talks about hell. He talks about how to live your life thereafter. And the principle of Jesus teaches us what to do, even while we are still alive here, that we can make our life better. You can't live like hell here because you want to live with God here. Sometimes if your life is in hell here, you will even miss heaven. Because if the care is not taken, if you are not so focused enough, you will see that the things of this world will derail you from making it to heaven. That's why I said, if you are poor enough on this earth, if you fail to follow the principle of Jesus on this earth, and your life become more miserable, devil have every grant to tell you that why are you worshiping God? And if you care is not taking, you will move and do what the world is doing. And that's why I said, if the principle of Jesus are not obeyed completely on this earth, and we became very poor, and things are not going the way God has said, we will be thinking, are you sure the Bible is right? And that is why I said the person of Jesus needs to be embraced and the principle of Jesus needs to be embraced. So that when you are focusing on things that you, after death you go to reign with him, then you go to focus on how to make sure that your bills are paid here on earth. To make sure how you go to live healthier here on earth. How to have peace with your home here on earth. And those who can get them in the principle of Jesus. Why am I saying this? Because the people in the world that are rich, all of them embrace the principle of Jesus. But they reject the person of Jesus. But we as Christians, we are encouraged to embrace the principle of Jesus, at the same time, embrace the person of Jesus. Because when you have both of them together, then when you are rich, you have peace. Everything will work according to the will of God. When you go to get the principle of Jesus and the person of Jesus, you will not stab your friend at the back because you want money. When you embrace both of them, you will not go and do something that is contrary because you have the fear of God in you, even while you are operating in the principle of Jesus. But you want the Bill Gates, all of them, they embrace only the principle, but not the person of Jesus. But this contest, we are encouraged to embrace both the principle and the person of Jesus. Who do you run to when you have issue? In this case, you must understand that there is a person of Jesus that can do miracle. There's a person of Jesus that can change story. There's a person of Jesus that can give life. There's a person of Jesus that can wipe away shame. And the mother run to him. You see, something is about to happen here. We need your divine intervention. And he gave them instruction, just like I've seen this morning. Put water. Give her the water. Those are instructions I was given. You know, it takes you faith to understand that we need wine and you are talking about water. Most of all, we question Jesus. Do you know what you are talking about? We say we need wine. He said, put water in the pot. It doesn't make any sense. Because such miracle has not been done before. Nobody has seen Jesus do anything before. It was the first miracle that Jesus would do. Nobody would have believed the young boy talking about water. We say we need wine, not water. We had a lot of water in here. Those are the excuses that most of us will give. That Jesus, probably you don't understand what we are talking about here. We said we need wine, not water. And this young boy said, put water in the pot. It takes your conviction to believe that. What is this guy talking about? To say, let me just understand and believe and understand and do what he has told me to do. It takes a conviction to get to that level. It takes a conviction for you to continue working as a Christian. To understand that our strength lies in him. Our ability lies in him. Our becoming lies in him. Whatever he told us to do, we just have to do it without questioning. We have questioned the audacity of Christ too much as Christians. We keep on asking questions about what he has told us to do. Several instructions laid down for you and myself to follow as Christians. Do this, you'll get this. Do this, you'll get this. Sometimes he advises us this way, don't follow it, follow this way. But some of us choose the way. He said we shouldn't follow. Why? Because we think it doesn't make sense. Jesus don't want to make sense. God doesn't have to make sense to you. He is the one that created sense. So he don't need to make sense. He created sense in the first place. So that's why his word doesn't make sense at the point in our life. We think, what is he talking about? How can you say give it and be given unto you? How can you say bless the poor when I still have my bill to pay? How can you say so? No, it doesn't make sense. But you say at this point, what has he told you to do? Have you done any one of them? In the place of obedience, do we see him as the priority? Do we see him that he knows what he's doing? Because when you know somebody knows what he's doing, you will obey him. American President Trump, when there was an insurrection in America, when they were attacking the lawmakers' building, the Capitol Hill, he was giving instruction to their military. He wanted them to go and attack them. But the military know Trump is out of his mind. They didn't obey his order completely. Why? because they don't. It's, of course, it's commander in charge. It's commander is in charge, but they understand this is a truncated order. So they were not convinced by the order yet. They were not convinced that it's constitutional based, and they do not obey the order completely. And that is where you and myself fall to sometimes. We are not convinced about the person of Jesus. We are not convinced that what he's saying is from our sent him. Even the world said that, that this might be God's son. Whoever believes in him works, we have what? But yet, the conviction is not there. To believe that Jesus is speaking for his father. To believe that Jesus has said it, we need to do it. That conviction is what we need for us to obey Christ. If you are not convinced, well, I know most of you still doubt if there is God. Because if you don't doubt if there is God, you will be convinced to obey him. It's only when you doubt, or you still have your doubt, or you are still thinking, probably it's a story, it's a book made up. Or probably it's not right. You know, some of us are so intelligent that we are looking at error, at conflicts in the Bible. This place conflict here. The Bible cannot conflict itself. You only need the Holy Spirit to teach you to understand. Because when you read it, your mindset, it will be all conflicted. But when you look back to the Bible, it was answered in the beginning. When you look back to the front, it was answered in the front. But when you take one part, and then, what is this we're talking about? Ask the Holy Spirit to tell you. It will tell you to go and look at some place at the back. Go and look in the front. The answer were all there. They are all, both Old and the New Testament, they were written, they were the inspiration of the Holy Spirit. And they cannot be mistaken. We have got to a place to say, no, the Bible speaks, we obey. We do what he do. We ask, we say what he says, and what he says we shouldn't do, we stay away from it. And that is where I want you to be. A place of conviction that when Jesus gave an instruction, we follow it wholeheartedly. Don't look at the circumstances before you take a decision. Don't look at what is good. Circumstances will always be there. But when you hold on to the person of Jesus, Jesus will only direct you and give you instruction. It doesn't matter what I'm going through today. Your next level is now. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. But you need to do exactly what he told you to do. I remember when I came newly to this country. A lot of things they tell you is not possible. But the person of Jesus is possible. They say, oh, we have come years ago. That was when I even came, I'm talking about 18 years ago now. They were telling me, why do you come this time? Europe is finished. You came too late. But I'm still here. Because the person of Jesus speaks. Don't live your life because of what you will get now. Live your life on what you will attain in the future. I was in the church. A woman has a passport. We don't even live in the same building. I came 3 months. She came with Nana passport. He said, Demola, this is your passport. I should just marry her. I said, no, I'm committed back home. He said, are you married to her? I said, no. He said, you don't know what your wife, your girlfriend, we are not married there. I said, but I'm committed to someone back home. I was even helping her to look for husband, but she was after me. I said, no. One day, I went to send the WhatsApp in the station. After I sent the money, before we get to it, our face was like looking at the money. She was angry. I said, but I told you. But thank God, she's married now. She lives in UK. And the husband is married. She's like man of God. She's very committed to church. They have come here one time when we were doing an anniversary. She's a very good friend of mine. I was looking for someone to marry her then, but everybody I've seen, they want the passport, not the woman. So I would tell her, no, I can't push the dish, the patient. But now she married a person just like a father and a friend. Very happy. In the house there, several ladies were here. When I was sitting in my room studying, they say, you never come out, brother. They will wear something, they want to entice me. But I stood my ground. And as God will have it, these same people in my former church, I was then preaching on the altar. They are now the member of the church.
I think about four of them. What if I've messed up with them and I show up on the altar? They can be called to leave the church. That is why you don't live your life now and think that I want to leave it anyhow and just whatever comes, I'll take it. No. Think about what we are going through. Every one of us have been designed with a future. Every one of us have a destiny that God himself has put a stamp on it. And your destiny cannot be taken away from you except you take it yourself. You see, what I tell you to do is a part to your destiny, is a part to your glory. You can get there. My life is full with testimony. I came as a leader, struggling. I said, I want to go to university. They said, it's not possible. I said, but I'm so educated. I want to go. They said, okay, they were laughing. How are you going to raise the money? And I went to university for 4 years. I was working the night, coming the morning to block, run to class. This is my first night in school, when we were there. What I was sleeping, he said, hey, hey, hey. I slept, I was sleeping in class. What am I trying to say? Jesus has a structure to life. Don't only run after the principle of Jesus. Take boots. It takes. While you are running with the person of Jesus, you can fall, you can rise, but don't stay on the floor. Don't let your friend keep you on the floor. Put your eyes on the person of Jesus. Don't let the things you are running after put you on the floor. Put your eyes on the person of Jesus. When you are taking the principle, you want to invest, you want to do business, make sure your business is focusing on the person of Jesus. Otherwise, the beast will be far from you, and the heaven will miss it. Because when your eyes is not on the person of Jesus, your eyes are only on the principle of Jesus. It's good for you to build a house. It's good for you to buy a house. It's good for you to own a car. But what is the person of Jesus? How? What priority have you given to Jesus? Have you allowed him to speak to you? Have you allowed him to take over your life? When he speaks, do you even understand? Have you allowed your conviction to get a place that once he speaks, I have to do it? The mother said, whatever he told you to do, just do it, because he knew he has the authority. And tell you this morning, whatever instruction that God has told you to do, if you start doing them now, it will be good and good for your family. It will wipe away your shame. It will wipe away your tears. It will silence your enemy. These kind of people were able to silence their enemy because Jesus steps in. I see people stepping into your spirit right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Because our Messiah steps in, their tears will wipe off. And then say, they were asking, why do you keep the best for last? Jesus is always giving the best. That's why I say, when you come last, it doesn't mean you are going to rank last. It only means you are going to beat the people in front. It only means you know how to do it better now. Because when I came, I met a lot of people. When I was going to university, they said, I will get a job. I said, let me finish first. You see, it's just wasting thousands of euros. All my money was going, thank God to my wife, when she was there. But when I came 1 year, I got her. We were just struggling together. After 4 years, thank God, after 3 months, I got my job. And people that are even younger than me haven't got a job. One of my lecturers then, he said, look at my age. He said, are you sure I don't know this is your age? I said, he said, you can't get a job this age. I said, sir, I will get a job. 3 months, I got a job. Even the younger one that will finish haven't got a job. What am I trying to say? Embrace the person of Jesus. Don't look at your circumstances and save your tomorrow. It is possible. It is possible. In human eyes, it's not possible. Water to wine, how could that be possible in human eyes? But it takes people of obedience. It takes people of conviction to take the action that Jesus said they should do. They knew that when they were pouring something in the pot, it was water. I now tell them again, draw from the water. It doesn't make sense. They are not saying Jesus just begin to draw. In their eyes, they pour the water. They saw it. They did it themselves. Not that because they did somebody did their thing. No. They are the one that pour the water. After pouring, they start drawing.
Your sowing will not go in vain in the name of Jesus Christ. I say your seed will not go in vain in the name of Jesus Christ. You see, Paul, then start drawing. You will reap the fruit of your labor in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I say you will reap the fruit of your labor in the name of Jesus Christ. You take conviction. My life is in wreck. You see, as a son of God, how will that match? I'm looking for something to eat. You see, as a bloody poor, how does that doesn't go together? But Jesus said, that's what I want to do. Your help to your family, you know, when you say help the poor, people will be looking at the son of their sister or the brother they are paying the school fees. Well, not beyond that. Do for people that you can't receive from. That's more important. That's more beneficial. That's what Christ pays. Everyone that you think means something that you are able to do, it can be little. Don't look at your wallet and your amount and say, I can't help from this. You can help from it if you want to. No amount is too small to help. You can share the little you have if you want to. Oh, I have to pay this bill. Because you don't want to, the zeal is not there to do it. If the zeal is there to help, it becomes one of your plans. I can't help the poor. I can't pay my tithes. I can't help the ministry. If you put in your plan, it becomes your plan. It takes your conviction on things to do. If you are not convicted, there's no way you can do it. These people, they put it, they saw it as water, and they bring it out. And that's why ordinary word from the word of God can live so, but your conviction attached to it. Can you go stand on my feet, please? I want to lift up your hand to heaven and say, Father, let the power of conviction in your word come upon me right now. The power to be convinced on your word. The power to be able to do your will. The power to follow you according to your will. Father, let it come upon me. In the name of Jesus. Let your power come upon me right now. In the name of Jesus. The power in your word, let it come upon me right now. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Before I go further, if anyone will spread a prayer, you want some, the church to stand and pray for you. If you have a spread a prayer, can you just come forward, please, while we pray for you as a church? Thank you, Jesus. Can we just lift up our hand towards our brother? I believe to pray for him with the sincerity of our hearts. Remember when you pray for and our sister has a, when you are praying for them, you are praying for yourself. Just say whatever that is in their hearts, the desire of their heart, according to the will of God. Let ever do it for them in the name of Jesus. Can we just lift up our voice and pray for them? Father, we lift up our brothers and sisters to your heaven hand and the baby. Father, Lord God, whatever that may be their heart desire, Father, let ever do it for them in the name of Jesus. Let's ever do it for them. In whichever way they believe in you for a miracle, a turnaround, a change of power. Father, intervene for them. Intervene for them. Intervene for them. In the name of Jesus. Lord, intervene. Intervene in their situation. Change their story. Thank you, Jesus. For in Jesus' name, we pray. Heavenly Father, lift your son and daughter to your heavenly hand. They have stepped forward to your altar. Let your altar fight for them.
Amen.
In every area of their life that they believe in you for a testimony, for a miracle, and a breakthrough, Lord, come sure for them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everything that's about to put them to shame, let them be put to shame in the name of Jesus. Every arrow that want to fire to their life, Father, let it go back to them in the name of Jesus Christ. Evil arrow that may be fired to them, Father, will return it now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We soak these ones in the blood of Jesus. Every negativity in their life will change them to positive in the name of Jesus. Every rejection will change to acceptance in the name of Jesus. Every weeping will wipe them off in the name of Jesus Christ. Every tears will wipe them off in the name of Jesus. That thing in their heart that they go bed to bed and cry to God, that God, when will you do it? Father, if you step forward today, Father, do it for them in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, fight their battle in the name of Jesus Christ. As they believe here today, I place a mark of touch not upon them. I place a mark of acceptance upon them. In the name of Jesus Christ, your case is different. In the name of Jesus, you might have seen people be deported, you might have seen people be disgraced. Your case is declared different as of now. In the name of Jesus Christ, go in peace. Take your testimony. Take your ability. For in Jesus' name we pray. Praise the Lord, somebody. Shout a bigger hallelujah. Can we lift up our offering up, sir? Can we lift up our offering up, please? Let's lift it up to God. Yes, be your name. Speak to whatever you want God to do for you. Speak to your offering. Whatever you want God to do, speak to your offering. Whatever you want Him to do, speak to your seed. Thank you, Jesus. Bless you, Holy Spirit. I'm so pleased. Thank you. For in Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I speak your power into every seed in the hand of your children. In the name of Jesus, Lord, as they will be sowing these seeds, let there be transformation in their life. In the name of Jesus, as they will be sowing to your kingdom, Father, let power of God visit them. In the name of Jesus, Lord, they said, we want a change in our life. We want something to transform our destiny. Lord, do it for them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, everywhere that this one has left them, let that their border of blessing coming back to them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every cankerworm, every power that eat people of this, I rebuke them for your sake. In the name of Jesus Christ. As from now, as you go forward, heaven shall go with you. The blessing of God will not depart from you. And everyone that are here that they want to give and they do not have, Lord, let your blessing locate them.
Amen.
Bless them, O Lord. Rebuke the border for their sake. In the name of Jesus Christ, give them a conviction to understand that God needs them to be sowing to. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, as we lead them today, let your glory go with us. For in Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Praise God, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Shout a bigger hallelujah. Praise the Lord, somebody. It is good to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is good to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is good to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is good to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is good to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is good to praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this service. I commit your children to your hand. As they journey through this week, Father, journey with them. I silence every altar speaking against them in the name of Jesus. As they go through this week, let there be testimony and breakthrough. I cancel every rejection upon their life in the name of Jesus. I put them under the shadow of Almighty.
Amen.
Let your power hold them.
Amen.
Whatever arrow the devil might be planning to fire, Lord, let your power stand in the gap for them.
Amen.
Every of their challenging, Father, let your spirit raise a standard against them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. This week will be a week of abundant breakthrough in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It will be a week of abundant blessing in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This week, your tears and weeping is wiped off in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
That pain in your heart, whatever that gives you grief, it is over in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I cover you with the blood of Jesus. Every power of suicide is committed to the hand of God and is destroyed today. In the name of Jesus Christ. I commit all our children to the hand of God. Devil will not power over them. In the name of Jesus Christ. Their destiny shall not be taken over. In the name of Jesus Christ. The devil will not sustain their glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I commit that those who are investing all in their business to the hand of God. Father, let there be a divine transformation.
Amen.
Let there be a breakthrough in their business. In the name of Jesus Christ, those who are sick right now, I believe the divine healing upon you. In the name of Jesus Christ, from your head to your toe, receive divine healing in the name of Jesus Christ. As you go forth today, whatever you touch, everyone shall touch. In the name of Jesus Christ, lift your hand above your head. As your hand are above your head, so shall you be above your enemy. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will be above sickness. You will be above poverty. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will be above rejection. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are above deportation. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are above failure. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you are above every power of the devil. In the name of Jesus Christ, as you go forward this hand, we carry breakthrough. We carry blessing. In the name of Jesus Christ, everything you touch shall be transformed for glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, those hands is connected to the resources of heaven. You will not lack any good thing. Everything is with our Father. God has everything in his inventory. He has your health, he has your breakthrough. As your hand is connected to the resources of heaven, your breakthrough is released to your hand. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are connected to your healing. You are connected to your status. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are connected to the power of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, receive that testimony, receive that breakthrough, receive that miracle. In Jesus' name, we pray. Praise the Lord, somebody. Shout hallelujah. Jesus, let us share the grace place in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit. Be with us now forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Praise the Lord, somebody. Shout a bigger hallelujah. Yes, Master Jesus. It is well within the name of Jesus Christ. Go and do well.